takes place next to a river, and it's got defies description, but it has got Aunt Fidget Wonkum Strong in it, and it's got a wonderful beginning. It says Tom lived with his Aunt Fidget Wonkum Strong. She took no nonsense from anybody. The flowers wilt anyway as she passes, and that's so nice because there's no she wore an iron hat. Sorry, of course she wore an iron hat and took no nonsense from anybody. Just to be told that about someone, and that she's the sort of figure of discipline, of an old-fashioned kind. You know, it's a wonderful start, so you can make a kind of Victorian figure of her and draw this, imagine what an iron hat is like, and draw her sort of pterodactyl-like face, and then invent Captain Najork and his hired sportsmen who are rowing up the river and so on and so on, and these games which are described but not described. Russell writes about them as though you knew what they were, you know, about wombling and sneedball and doing these things in the mud. And so that was a marvellous thing to do, because there were a lot of promptings for the illustrator to invent these people. And you could decide. I didn't tell you that it was Edwardian, but I thought that was what it ought to be. And that was the first of a number of books that I did with Russell. And in fact, he was invited to write a sequel to it, and that was called A Near Thing for Captain Najork. And I thought it was... I didn't see how he could write a sequel to it initially, because, well, the original story is perfectly formed. It's a sort of educational fable, and it's got a bit of other books in it. It's got a little bit of sort of Hard Times in it, and a bit of Huckleberry Finn or something like that. I mean, it's about how people who do things spontaneously and skillfully for that reason are more effective than people who learn things by rote, because that's the one thing. Actually, there is, I have got the postcard that Russell gave me, which is, there is a Victorian engraving of Captain Najork, and it doesn't say, you know, you don't know, there are these chaps rowing in a rowing boat. And of course it was Russell's brilliance that he looked at that picture and knew they were hired sportsmen, with everything that was kind of implied in that. And it's a wonderful education. It's perfectly formed educational fable. And so I couldn't see, you know, how you could write another educational fable. And it was extraordinary when I got it, because it was, he said, got it down to 2 pages of typing. You know, he actually managed to write an even shorter text. And in fact, what it is he wrote a sequel as farce, which is a completely different form in that things happen, come together, as it were, by accident, which produce other things. And it's in that Tom, you know, invents a jam-powered frog, and they're going down the river, and there was Captain Najork's got the hired sportsman with this mobile snake and so on. But I mean, the way that things come together is a sort of, it's the structure is farce, but you could use the same people. And in fact, it was very nice, because when I remember saying to Russell, I didn't know how you could write a sequel. I thought it was extraordinary. And he said, well, by then I knew what the people looked like, which helped, which just made me feel, well, you know, it was good to be in that collaboration. And we've done other books since.